Hola.
Don't tell me you didn't know it was loaded. Can't he do something constructive like start an avalanche or something?
When you start to eat like this, something is the matter.
Sylvia, I'm getting a divorce.
What? From Charles?
He's the only husband I have. I've tried to make it work, really, I have, but...
But what?
Oh, I can't explain. It's just that I'm too miserable to go on any longer like this.
It is infuriating that your unhappiness does not turn to fat. But I don't understand. Why do you want a divorce?
Because I don't love him. And he obviously doesn't love me.
But that's no reason to get a divorce. With a rich husband and this year's clothes, you won't find it difficult to make some new friends.
Look, I admit I came to Paris to escape American provincial, but... But that doesn't mean I'm ready for French traditional. I loathe the whole idea of divorce, Sylvie. I loathe the whole idea of divorce, Sylvie. But if only Charles had been honest with me, that... That's all I ask of anybody, the simple truth. But with Charles, everything is secrecy and lies.
He's hiding something from me, Sylvie. Something terrible. And it frightens me.
Does he belong to you?
It's hers. Where'd you find him? Robbing a bank?
He was throwing snowballs at Baron Rothschild.
Oh, thank you.
Do we know each other?
Why do you think we're going to?
I don't know. How would I know?
Because I already know an awful lot of people and... Until one of them dies, I couldn't possibly meet anyone else.
Well, if anyone goes on the critical list, let me know.
Quitter.
Uh-huh.
You give up awfully easily, don't you?
Viens, Jean-Louis, let us make a walk. I've never seen a Rothschild before.
Clever fellow. Almost missed me. Thank you.
You're blocking my view.
Oh. Which view would you prefer?
The one you're blocking. See, it's my last chance. I'm flying back to Paris this afternoon. What? What's your name?
Peter Joshua.
Oh, mine's Regina Lambert.
Is there a Mr. Lambert?
Yes. Yes.
Good for you.
No. No, it isn't. I'm getting a divorce.
Please, not on my account.
Oh, no, you see, I don't really love him.
Well, at least you're honest.
Is there a Mrs. Joshua?
Yes, but we're divorced.
Oh, that wasn't a proposal. I'm just curious.
Is your husband with you?
Oh, no, Charles is never with me. What do people call you? Pete?
Mr. Joshua. I've enjoyed talking with you.
Oh, now you're angry.
No. No, no, I'm not angry. I just have a lot of packing to do. I'm going back to Paris, too.
Well, wasn't it Shakespeare who said, when strangers do meet in far-off lands, they should ere long see each other again?
Shakespeare never said that.
How do you know?
It's terrible. You just made it up.
Well, it sounds right. You gonna call me?
Are you in the book?
Well, Charles is.
Is there only one Charles Lampert?
Lord, I hope so. Goodbye, Sylvie, and thanks.
When you get your divorce, are you going back to America?
Well, don't you want me to stay?
Yes, of course, but if you went back and wrote me a letter,
you you could have the stamps. I'll get you some here, okay?
Okay.
Goodbye.
Honorine?
Madame Charles Lampert.
Yes.
I'm Inspector Edouard Grandpierre of the police judiciaire. Would you be so kind as to come with me, please? Well, madame. You're positive? You loved him? We discovered your husband's body. Lying next to the tracks of the Paris-Bordeaux railroad line. He was dressed only in his pajamas. Do you know of any reason why he might have wanted to leave France?
Leave? No.
Your husband possessed a ticket of passage on the Maringuape. It sailed for Venezuela this morning at 7.
I'm very confused.
He was American, your husband?
Swiss.
Swiss. His profession?
He didn't have one.
He was a wealthy man.
I suppose so. I don't know.
About how wealthy would you say?
I don't know.
Where did he keep his money?
I don't know.
Beside yourself, who is his nearest relative?
I don't know.
That's absurd, madame. Totalement absurd.
I know. I'm sorry.
It is all right?
I wish you wouldn't.
On Wednesday last, your husband sold the entire contents of the apartment at public auction. Everything. The gallery paid him 1,250,000 new francs. In dollars, a quarter of a million. The authorities in Bordeaux searched this compartment on the train. They searched it thoroughly. They did not find $250,000. These few things are all that was found in the train compartment. There was no other baggage. Your husband must have been in a great hurry. One wallet containing 4,000 francs. One agenda. His last notation was made yesterday. Thursday, 5 p.m., Jardin des Champs-Élysées. Why there?
I don't know. Perhaps he met somebody.
Obviously. One ticket of passage to South America. One letter, stamped but unsealed, addressed to you.
May I see it, please?
My dear Regina, I hope you're enjoying your holiday. Megève can be so lovely at this time of year. The days pass very slowly, and I hope to see you soon. As always, Charles. P.S. Your dentist called yesterday. Your appointment has been changed. Not much, is it?
We took the liberty of calling your dentist. We thought perhaps we would learn something. We thought perhaps we would learn something.
Did you?
Yes. Your appointment has been changed. One key to your apartment. One comb. One fountain pen. One toothbrush. One tin of tooth powder. That is all. If you will sign this list, you may take the things with you.
Is that all? May I leave now?
One more question. Is this your husband's passport?
Yes.
And this?
I don't understand.
And this? And this?
Oh, I telephoned, but nobody answered. Hello. Hello. I wanted to tell you how sorry I am. And see if there's anything I can do.
How did you find out?
It's in the afternoon papers.
I'm very sorry.
Thank you.
I pressed the bell, but it isn't ringing, I guess.
I know there's no electricity.
Well, where did everything go?
Charles sold it all at auction. This is all I have left. I love this room, but Charles never really saw it. Only the things in it. I think I prefer it this way.
What are you going to do?
Try and get my old job back at Uresco, I suppose.
Doing what?
I'm a simultaneous translator, like Sylvie. Only she's English into French and I'm French into English. That's what I was doing before I married Charles. Police probably think I killed him.
Instant divorce, you mean?
Something like that. It's terrible it ended this way, though. Tossed off a train like a sack of third-class mail.
Well, come on, you can't stay here.
Where to go?
We'll find you a hotel.
Nothing too expensive.
I'm not a lady of leisure anymore, you know.
Something clean and modest, and near enough to your resco so that you can take a cab when it rains. Okay?
Okay. Not a very large turnout, is it? Didn't Charles have any friends? Don't ask me, I'm only the widow. If Charles had died in bed, we wouldn't even have him. If Charles had died in bed, we wouldn't even have him. If Charles had died in bed, we wouldn't even have him.
At least he knows how to behave at funerals. Have you no idea who could have done it?
Until 2 days ago, the only thing I really knew about Charles was his name. Now it seems I didn't even know that.
He must have known Charles pretty well.
How can you tell?
He's allergic to him. You know him?
Never seen him before.
Miss Lampert, ma'am? Miss Lampert, ma'am. Charlie had no call of doing it that way. No siree.
What next?
Who's it from?
American Embassy.
I bluffed the old man out of the last pot with a pair of deuces.
What's so depressing about that?
Well, I mean, if I can do it, what are the Russians doing to him?
Hello? Hello?
Is there anything wrong, Miss Tompkins?
Miss Tompkins isn't here.
Oh, I'm sorry. My secretary must have gone to lunch. You are...
Mrs. Lambert, Mrs. Charles Lambert.
Oh, yes. Please, come in, Mrs. Lambert. Excuse me for a moment, Mrs. Lambert. It's a stubborn little devil. Dry cleaning-wise, things are all fouled up. I had a good man, a really excellent man, in the Rue Pontou. But HQ asked us to use the plant here in the building to ease the gold outflow.
Mr. Bartholomew, are you quite sure you know who I am?
You're Charles Lambert's widow, yes? I'm very sorry. Last time I sent out a tie, only the spot came back. Voila, as they say. Won't you sit down, Mrs. Lambert? I've got something here. I've got liverwurst, liverwurst, chicken, and liverwurst. I've got liverwurst, liverwurst, chicken, and liverwurst. I've got liverwurst, liverwurst, chicken, and liverwurst.
No, thank you.
Mrs. Lampert, do you know what CIA is?
I don't suppose it's an airline, is it?
Central Intelligence Agency, CIA.
You mean spies and all of that?
Only we call them agents.
We? You mean you?
Someone has to do it, Mrs. Lappin.
It's just that I didn't think people like you were supposed to admit.
Oh, I'm not an agent. I'm an administrator, a desk jockey. Trying to run a bureau of overworked men with under-allocated... funds. Congress seems to think that all a spy needs...
agent.
Yes. That all he needs is a code book, a cyanide pill, and he's in business.
What's all this got to do with me, Mr. Bartholomew?
Your husband was wanted by the United States government.
May I have a sandwich, please?
Chicken or liverwurst?
Chicken.
To be more specific, Mrs. Lampert, your husband was wanted by this agency. To be more specific, Mrs. Lampert, your husband was wanted by this agency.
So that was it.
Yeah.
Yes. We, of course, knew him by his real name. Voss. Charles Voss. All right, Mrs. Voss. Now, I'd like you to look at this photograph here for a moment, please. Tell us if you recognize... Oh. By the way, have you seen this one? Scott, Kathy, and Ham Jr.
Very sweet.
Aren't they? All right. Hey, Mrs. Voss.
Please stop calling me that. Lambert's the name on the marriage license.
Oh. I'm terribly sorry. Miss Lambert, would you look at that photograph and tell me if you recognize anyone, please? Now, just a moment. Have a good look.
It's Charles.
Very good.
He looked so young when was this taken?
~1944. Next, please.
The man who was at the funeral yesterday. A tall man in a corduroy suit.
Does the name Tex Penthollow mean anything to you?
No.
You like some wine?
Oh, thank you.
Next, please.
He was there, too. A little less hair, but it's the same one.
Do you know him, Mrs. Lampert? Leopold W. Gideon? Do you know him, Mrs. Lampert? Leopold W. Gideon?
No.
The last one, please.
That's a face you don't forget. He was there, too.
Herman Scobie. You've never seen him before, either?
No, thank heaven.
Mrs. Lambert, I'm very much afraid that you are in a great deal of danger.
Why should I be in any danger?
You're Charles Voss's wife. You're Charles Voss's wife. Now that he's dead, you're their only lead.
Mr. Bartholomew, if you're trying to frighten me... You're doing a first-rate job.
Please do what we ask, Mrs. Lambert. It's your only chance.
Gladly, but I don't know what you want. You haven't told me.
Oh, I haven't? Well, it's the money, Mrs. Lambert. The money. Of $250,000 Charles Voss received from the auction. Of $250,000 Charles Voss received from the auction. Those three men want it, too. They want it very badly.
But that's Charles's money, not theirs.
Oh, Mrs. Lambert, I'd love to see you try and convince them of that. Oh, my.
But then whose is it? His or theirs?
Ours.
Oh.
Charles Voss stole $250,000 from the United States government. I'm afraid we want it back.
But I don't have it.
That's impossible, Mrs. Lampard. You're the only one who could have it.
Mr. Bartholomew, if I had $250,000... Believe me, I'd know it.
Nevertheless, Mrs. Lampert, you've got it.
You mean he's just lying around somewhere? All that cash?
Or a certified check, a safe deposit key, baggage claim. Or a certified check, a safe deposit key, baggage claim. You look for it, Mrs. Lambert. I'm quite sure you'll find it. Look for it. Look just as hard and as fast as you can. You may not have a great deal of time. Those three men know you've got the money just as surely as we do. You won't be safe until the money is in our hands. Is that clear? Now, here's where you ought to call me, day or night. It's a direct line to both my office and my apartment. And please don't tell anyone about coming to see us today. It could
It could prove fatal for them as well as yourself.
As I said, Mrs. Lambert, I'm afraid you're in a great deal of danger. I regret very much having to say this, but please remember what happened to your husband.
Hello.
Hello, Peter.
Now, didn't you telephone me to meet you on that corner over there?
I'm sorry, I heard the children laughing. Do you understand French?
Not a word. I'm still having trouble with English.
The man and the woman are married.
Oh, I can see that. They're batting each other over the head. Who's that with the hat?
That's the policeman. He wants to arrest Judy for killing Punch.
What's she saying now?
That she's innocent. She didn't do it.
Oh, she did it all right.
I believe her.
Well, who was that?
That's Punch, of course.
Punch, of course. I thought he was dead.
He's only pretending to teach her a lesson. Only he is dead, Peter. I saw him. He's not pretending. Somebody threw him off a train. Charles was mixed up in something terrible. What am I going to do?
I wish you'd let me help you. It doesn't sound like the sort of thing a young woman can handle by herself. It doesn't sound like the sort of thing a young woman can handle by herself. It doesn't sound like the sort of thing a young woman can handle by herself. How about making me vice president in charge of cheering you up?
Starting tonight?
Gentlemen, what's going on?
Fun and games. Evidently, we're the floor show. Come on.
What, you and me?
Everyone.
Put the order that you like so. You pass the order to the person behind you. Of your hands. Are you ready?
Mrs. Lampert.
Who are you?
Didn't Charles tell you, Mrs. Lampert?
Tell me what?
It doesn't belong to you. You do know that, don't you?
I don't know anything.
Mrs. Lampert. Any morning now, you could wake up dead, Mrs. Lampert.
Leave me alone.
Dead, Mrs. Lampert, like last week's news, like Charles, Mrs. Lampert.
Stop it!
What's the trouble?
stepped on my foot.
Forgive me.
Wait here, I won't be long.
It was quite unintentional, I'm sure.
Mr. Bartholomew, this is Regina Lambert. Mr. Bartholomew, I just saw one of those men. Mr. Bartholomew, can you hear me? Mr. Bartholomew, this is Regina Lambert. I just...
Howdy.
What do you want?
Now you must be kidding.
No, I'm not.
Now, come on now, Miss Lambert. You know what it is? You're gonna get it for me, too. You know I ain't fooling around here. No, sir, Bob.
No, that's me.
Now, don't.
Please
now, don't
stop.
Make too much noise, Miss Lambert. Oh. It could get a whole lot worse, you know. Belongs to me, Miss Lambert. And you're gonna get it for me. Life ain't gonna be worth the paper it's printed on. You say what I'm saying to you? Go home and take it over real careful right now.
What are you doing in here?
having a nervous breakdown.
Now hold it. I waited long enough. What happened back there?
I'm not sure if I'm supposed to tell you or not.
What does that mean?
He said if I told anybody, it could prove fatal for them as well as for me. He said if I told anybody, it could prove fatal for them as well as for me.
Who said?
That's what I'm not supposed to say.
Now stop that nonsense.
Stop. Stop bullying me. Everybody's bullying me.
I'm not bullying
you. Way.
Yes,
well, you said it was nonsense. Being murdered in cold blood is not nonsense. Why don't you try it sometime? Would you mind seeing me to the door?
Of course not.
It's a good place for making friends.
You said this afternoon your husband was mixed up in something.
How do you shave in there?
What was it?
What was what?
What your husband was mixed up in.
Look, I know it's asking you to stretch your imagination, but... don't you think you could pretend just for a moment that I'm a woman? No.
Now listen, I could already be arrested for transporting a minor above the first floor. Here you are.
Where?
On the street where you live.
How about once more around the park?
How about getting out of here? Come on, child, out.
Won't you come in for a minute?
No. No, I won't.
I don't bite, you know. Unless it's called for.
How would you like a spanking?
How'd you like a punch in the nose? Stop treating me like a child.
Well, then stop behaving like one. Now, if you want to tell me what's troubling you, fine. If not, I'm tired, it's late, and I want to go home to bed.
Do you know what's wrong with you?
No, what?
Nothing.
Where is it, Lee?
I don't know.
I want it. Give it to me. It's mine!
Oh, Peter! Peter! A man tried to kill me! Peter? Peter, are you all right? Oh, Peter, are you hurt?
I sprained my pride. How are you?
Scared.
You'll be all right.
Where did he go?
Out the window, I guess.
Well, lock the door. Don't let anyone in except me.
And close these windows after me.
Be careful.
You just took the words right out of my mouth.
Now, Pamela.
It happened again. Another strange man peered in the window at me and then went away.
Bad luck, Pamela. That was a dumb move.
I'm a man, and then some. He'd only let us know he was going up to our room. We could have done something to keep him busy. And sneaking off up there that way by yourself. Man, what did you expect him to do? Walk up and shake you by that hand of yours.
Dumb move, Herman, a dumb move.
Yes, it was a dumb move, Herman. What is the matter with you?
You want some more?
Never mind that.
Did you get the money?
How could I with the three Marx brothers breathing down my neck? I thought we had an agreement. Now the girl trusts me. If she's got the money, I'll find out about it. But you just leave me alone.
If she's got the money, I'll find out about it. But you just leave me alone.
We took all the chances. The money belongs to us, not to him. We took all the chances. The money belongs to us, not to him.
Now don't be piggy, Herman. A third of nothing is nothing. Just think about that. A third of nothing is nothing. Just think about that. Make up your mind. She's waiting for me.
I don't see how another 24 hours could hurt anything.
Oh, shoot.
Shoot, no, not after all these years.
Then he gets it out of your share. Not mine. Not mine.
Either one of you got the room next to it?
Yeah, I have. Why?
Give me the key. Get yourself another room. I want to use it.
But if you do find that money, you ain't going to forget to tell your buddies about it, are you?
Don't worry.
Oh, no, I ain't worrying. You see this little fella here? Oh, he worries. And he's even meaner than I am.
Who is it?
It's me, Peter. There was no trace of him. Why don't you confide in me and tell me what this is all about?
There are three men He's one of them. They think I have $250,000 that belongs to them.
Go on.
That's all.
No, it isn't. Where's the money?
I don't know. They killed Charles to get it, but he must not have had it with him on the train.
So they think he left it with you.
I've looked everywhere, and if I don't find it, they're going to kill me. But he didn't. I've looked everywhere, and if I don't find it, they're going to kill me.
No, they won't. I won't let them.
Peter, help me. You're the only one I can trust.
I'll help you. I told you I would.
Come on.
Oh, I'm so hungry, I could faint. And I've gotten your suit all wet.
That's all right, it's a drip dry. Wipe your eyes.
Promise me you'll never lie to me the way Charles did. Why do people have to tell lies?
Usually it's because they want something. They're afraid the truth won't get it for them.
You tell lies. Hello?
Mrs. Lambert, it's me. The man who was in your room a few minutes ago.
What do you want?
Who is it?
It's the man you had the fight with.
Is Dial with you?
Who?
The man I had the fight with, lady. Dial. That's his name. What's wrong? Is he still there?
Yes. That's right.
What's he saying?
Don't trust him. Don't tell him anything. He's after the money.
What was all that about?
He said if I don't give him the money, he'll kill me.
Oh, don't take it seriously. He's just trying to frighten you.
I believe what he said.
No, no, it's just a lot of words.
Words can hurt.
Try to get some sleep. You'll feel better. Don't worry. I've arranged to take the room next door to you. So you'll be all right. If you want anything, just bang on the wall. Better lock the door after me. Good night.
But I am calm, Mr. Bartholomew. What I'm trying to say is that... is that there's someone else.
What?
Someone who wasn't in that photograph you showed me today. He says his name is Peter Joshua, but it isn't. It's Dial. Are you still there, Mr. Bartholomew?
Yes, Miss Lampett. I don't know who this Mr. Dial is, but... But it's just possible we were wrong about who killed your husband.
You mean he might have? Mr. Bartholomew, I'm catching the next plane out of here. I'm not going to sit around for somebody to make chopped liver out of me.
Now, take it easy, Mrs. Lambert. Take it easy. Where are you now? Can you meet me at the market?
At Leal?
Yeah. Yes, opposite San Eustache. Yes, opposite San Eustache. I'll meet you there in 15 minutes.
All right, I'll be there in 15 minutes.
Were you followed?
Yes, by Dial, but I lost him. I'm beginning to think women make the best spies.
Agents.
He has a gun, Mr. Bartholomew.
No.
But I saw it.
No. No, that's not caution dialed.
Carson?
There's only one Dial connected with this affair, Mrs. Lampett. That's Carson Dial.
You mean you've known about him all along?
It's enough to make you a vegetarian, isn't it?
It's just lucky that I'm not hanging next to one of those things right now. It's just lucky that I'm not hanging next to one of those things right now. Why didn't you tell me you knew about Dial?
I didn't see any point. Dial's dead.
Mr. Bartholomew, what is all this about?
In 1944, five members of the OSS the military espionage unit were ordered behind the German lines for the purpose of delivering $250,000 in gold to the French underground. The five men were, of course, your husband Charles, the three men who showed up at his funeral yesterday, and Carson Dial.
Oh.
But instead of delivering the gold, they stole it. Burying it. Then reporting the Germans had captured it. All they had to do was come back after the war, dig it up, and split it five ways. $250,000 with no questions asked.
May I have a cigarette, please? I can't stand those things. It's like drinking coffee through a veil.
Everything went smoothly enough until after the gold was buried. Then before they could get out, they were ambushed by a German patrol. A machine gun separated Scobie from his right hand. Caught Carsendale full in the stomach. What's wrong with that one?
Nothing, I guess. What happened then?
Have you any idea what these things cost?
Please go on. Please go on, Mr. Bartholomew. What happened then?
Carsendale was dead, but Scobie was able to travel. So where was I?
Carsendale was dead.
Yes, Carsendale was dead. The others finally got back to the base and waited for the war to end. Only Charles couldn't wait quite as long as the others. He beat them back to the goal, took everything for himself, and disappeared. It's taken Gideon, Tex, and Scobie all this time to catch up with him again.
But if they stole all that money, why can't you arrest them?
We know what happened from the bits and pieces we were able to piece together. We know what happened from the bits and pieces we were able to piece together. We still have no proof.
What's this got to do with the CIO?
CIA, Mrs. Lappin. It's an extension of the wartime OSS. It's our money and we want it back.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bartholomew, but nothing you've said has changed my mind. I'm leaving Paris tonight.
Wouldn't advise that, Mrs. Lampin. Better consider what happened to your husband when he tried to leave. Those men won't be very far away, no matter where you're going. In fact, I don't even see any point in your changing hotel. Now, please help us, Mrs. Lampin. Your government is counting on you.
Well, I suppose if I'm going to die, I might as well do it for my country.
That's the spirit. Here's what I want you to do. We're anxious to know who this man is, the one calling himself Dial. I want you to find out.
Why me?
You're in an ideal position. He trusts you. Besides, you yourself said women make the best spies. Besides, you yourself said women make the best spies.
Agents. Oh, pardon. What are you doing following me? It's gonna look like a parade.
Stop it! How are you? How nice to see you. When did you arrive? It's lovely town to stay. Are you having a good time? So many things to see. If you don't stop following me, I'll call the police.
Dial, please. D-Y-L-E.
Yes, Mr. Dial, I remember. No, I'm sorry, Mr. Dial. Nothing today.
Thank you.
Mr. Dial, please. You're wanted on the telephone. Mr. Dial, cabin 4.
Yes?
Good morning, Mr. Dial.
Reggie?
It's the only name I've got. How about you?
I know, Cat and Mouse, you've got me. What do you want to know?
Why you lied to me?
I had to. For all I knew, you were in on the whole thing.
I'm trying to find out who you are.
But you know my name, it's Dial.
Carson Dial is dead.
Yes, he is. He was my brother.
Your brother?
The army thinks he was killed in action by the Germans. But I think they did it. Tex, Gideon Scobie, and your husband. Because my brother wouldn't go along with their scheme to steal the gold.
I think he threatened to turn them in, and they killed him. I'm trying to prove it. They think I'm working with them, but I'm not, Reggie. I'm on your side. Just believe that.
How can I? You lied to me just the way Charles did. After promising you wouldn't. Oh, I want to believe you, Peter. Oh, I can't call you that anymore, can I? Take me a while to get used to your new name. What is it? Hello? Hello?
Do anything funny or try to talk to anyone, I'll kill you, Dial.
You'll wreck your raincoat.
Take the next car, please.
Look out. Didn't want you to bump your head.
I get in there. Turn around. Now sit down.
Now what?
We wait with our mouth shut.
Sorry about that.
Okay, up there.
Do I knock or something?
No. Open it. Keep right on going.
The view, it better be worth it. Very pretty. Now what? I was afraid of that.
I'll give you a chance, Dial. Which is more than you'd give me. I'll give you a chance, Dial. Which is more than you'd give me. Where's the money?
Is that why you dragged me all the way up here to... to ask me that? She has it.
And I say maybe you both have it. One more time, Dial. Where is it?
Supposing I had it, which I don't. Do you really think I'd just hand it over to you?
Step back.
Back. Back where?
That's the idea.
Now, just a minute. Take it easy.